Hackney's Labour Council was elected in 1982 on the policy of three very definite no's. No rent increases above the rate of inflation, no rate increases, and no cuts in services. But within just 2 years, one of those no's became a resounding yes.
Faced with a decreasing rate support grant and a hostile government, Hackney upped its rates this year by 17%, and that led directly to the dismissal of the council leader. Unlike most boroughs, Hackney's leader is chosen by an electoral college, councillors plus constituency party members. At the Borough Labour Party's annual meeting, they voted to continue the manifesto policy. Leader Anthony Kendall argued against it because he believed it meant overspending, possible bankruptcy and a confrontation with Whitehall. But he was defeated by Councillor Hilda Keane, a local schoolteacher, by just 13 votes.
It's not just a question of people's living standards being affected, but local people have been confused about who's making the cuts. Is it the government or the council? And what we made very clear by our opposition to the rate capping proposals, that no longer are we going to pass on any cuts to local people, but we are going to make it very clear those cuts come from the government, and therefore the government must be confronted on that basis.
But if, as your critics say, that you bankrupt the council, and if the government move in, you will no longer represent the people of Hackney. You will have lost that battle, surely.
The ball is not in my court. The ball is in the government's court.
At the annual meeting, only 14 of the total 50 Labour councillors supported Hilda Keane. Hackney's electoral college may want the policy, but the Labour group is hardly as enthusiastic.
You see, the Labour Party is absolutely divided on this matter, as indeed they are on many other matters, and I'm quite confident that a good reason will prevail and that they will not implement these policies.
I've lived in Hackney for most of my life. I was born here, I know the conditions here, and therefore I think that us in the Labour Party locally know far better about this situation than Maggie Thatcher does sat in Westminster.
But you're quite prepared to be in a position where you might actually be personally surcharged.
Yes, I am.
The Department of the Environment said this afternoon that if the rates could not cover the services in Hackney, then local councillors could well find themselves surcharged for the extra cost. And if this borough does go bankrupt, then central government will run its essential services. Lindsay Charlton in Hackney, Thames News.